It's time to roll up our sleeves and get our hands dirty. This episode is all about setting up your very own hacking lab, a safe, isolated environment where you can practice and hone your hacking skills without causing harm or breaking any laws. Before we dive in, let's talk about why a hacking lab is important. It's like a sandbox where you can freely explore, make mistakes, and learn from them. It's your personal playground where you can try out new tools, techniques, and ideas. And the best part? You can do all this without the risk of damaging real systems or violating any laws. Setting up your lab will involve creating a virtual machine. For those of you who are new to this, a virtual machine or VM is a software emulation of a computer system. It operates based on the architecture of a host machine. Think of it as a computer within a computer, cordoned off from your main operating system, where you can do whatever you want without affecting your real computer. Now, there are several tools out there that you can use to create a VM. The ones we'll focus on today are VirtualBox and VMware. Both are excellent options, with VirtualBox being free and open source, and VMware offering more advanced features in its paid version. We'll link to some great guides on how to set up a VM in the descriptions. But first, let's discuss setting up a VM and what it really means. If you've set up a VM before, let us know in the comments which software you used and why you prefer it. While you can technically use any OS for ethical hacking, Kali Linux is a favorite among many ethical hackers. Kali Linux is a Debian-based Linux distribution designed for digital forensics and penetration testing. It comes preloaded with a lot of security tools like Wireshark, Nmap, and Metasploit, which makes it a ready-to-use platform for ethical hacking. Installing Kali Linux is a straightforward process, and I'll link to a step-by-step guide. From downloading the ISO file from the official Kali website to setting up the VM to boot from this ISO, you'll see it all. While Kali Linux is an excellent choice for ethical hacking, it's important to remember it's just a tool. Mastering ethical hacking doesn't depend on one tool or operating system. It's about understanding concepts, techniques, and strategies, and being able to apply them effectively. By the end of this week, you'll have your very own ethical hacking lab up and running. You'll be ready to start exploring, learning, and developing your ethical hacking skills in a safe and controlled environment. But remember, with great power comes great responsibility. The skills you're learning should only be used ethically, to protect and secure systems, not to exploit or harm them. So let's get started with some expert tips. Always consider the specifications of your host machine when setting up your VM. Creating a VM can be quite resource intensive. For example, if your host machine only has 4 GB of RAM, and you allocate 2 GB to your VM, you could cause both systems to underperform. Make sure you have enough memory, processing power, and storage capacity to handle the VM alongside your normal operations. Be extremely cautious when downloading ISO files for your VM. Only use trusted sources like the official Kali Linux website. Downloading from an unverified source might risk introducing malware into your safe environment, defeating the purpose of an isolated hacking lab. Regularly updating your host machine's antivirus software is crucial. Even though you're working inside a VM, there's still a small risk that a particularly destructive piece of malware could break out of the VM and affect your host system. Keeping your antivirus software up to date adds an extra layer of protection. Make liberal use of VM snapshots. These are like save points in video games. Before you start experimenting with a new tool or technique, take a snapshot of your VM. If something goes awry, you can simply revert to the snapshot and your VM will return to the state it was in when you took the snapshot, preventing permanent damage. Kali Linux is a favorite among ethical hackers, but don't restrict yourself to just one OS. Others, like Parrot OS, also offer a robust set of tools for penetration testing and digital forensics. By working with different systems, you can develop a more versatile skill set. Invest your time in learning the command line interface in Kali Linux. While the GUI can make tasks easier, many powerful tools and techniques require command line usage. For instance, tools like Nmap have more extensive functionality when used through the command line as compared to their graphical counterparts. Ethical hacking is not just about acquiring technical skills. Developing a hacker's mindset, being curious, persistent, and detail-oriented, is equally important. For example, if you're facing a complex problem, don't give up. Instead, try to think outside the box. Often, solutions require an unconventional approach. Don't just rely on pre-installed tools in Kali Linux. There's a vast range of third-party tools available. Check the description below for a downloadable checklist and toolkit for ethical hackers. For example, Burp Suite is an excellent web application security testing tool that isn't included by default in Kali. Explore and find the ones that work best for your needs. Remember the legal implications of hacking. Even in your isolated VM, ensure all your actions comply with the law. For instance, practicing phishing attacks should only be done with explicit consent and within your secure environment, never on unsuspecting individuals. Community is key in this field. Join forums, attend webinars, and network with other ethical hackers. Websites like Stack Overflow or GitHub can provide a wealth of information and practical insights from professionals in the field. Also, we've included some links to guides on how to set up a virtual machine. For those of you interested in exploring beyond VirtualBox and VMware, there are other VM software options available, like Hyper-V for Windows users and QEMU, an open-source hardware virtualizer. Each tool comes with its own set of features and capabilities, so do your research to find the one that suits your needs best. Now, I would love to hear from you. What are your thoughts on setting up an ethical hacking lab? Have any additional tips or resources to share with the community? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe for our next episode in this series, where we're going to learn about reconnaissance. Often the first step in ethical hacking, reconnaissance involves gathering information about the target system. We'll learn how to use tools like Nmap for network scanning, Wireshark for packet analysis, and Nessus for vulnerability scanning. We'll also delve into the art of social engineering, a technique used to exploit human vulnerabilities. After this week, you'll be equipped to gather essential information about your target and identify potential weak spots.